Welcome to Tales from the Caveside, where Lillian and Chris, we bought a cave house and finca on the outskirts of a small Spanish town. Follow us as we learn to renovate and create a home that we will be proud of.
And Chris has come up with a cunning plan. I'll come over to have a look, see what it is. We have this recess here that actually we originally think went all the way through. You can sort of see where the marks were. On the other side there is a similar recess, so we think it went all the way through. It had a tap coming out of it originally, and they had a bar here. But this is original marble that was here. It's now no longer really in keeping with everything that we've done. So Chris is suggesting that he's going to cut this marble, take away this sticky out bit, and then we'll tile it with these tiles that we've done the other shelves with. And I think it's a good idea because it'll then tie this side in with that side with the same patterns. Right, yes, I approve. The line is straight.
Yes.
We'll go for it.
Yes. I actually did this all on my own. And I used masking tape so I could see a line, because there's no point in marking it with a pen, because I'm going to see it.
We're going to see it now.
Yeah. Right. I'll get on with it.
Right, that's Chris PPE'd up. I put a fan there so it blows dust hopefully out.
Yes.
Some of it's going to go in that room, but something we do about it.
I've drifted a little bit, but I'll fix it.
Okay.
So the dust was horrendous. I've still got this little bit to knock off. The blade wasn't quite deep enough to go all the way to the bottom, but it's nearly. So I just tapped that a little bit off. This piece here. I'm just going to do the same with this. There we go. There's a little bit of chiseling work to do there. I'll get that a little bit fixed, tacked out. I'm going to break it. I know it doesn't matter. And I just need to chisel a little bit there. And then that is ready for tiles to be put on it. And I'll show you what other solution we'll come up with because of this sharp edge. I just chiseled them little bits out. Broke some of the plaster, but we can fix that. What do you think? Just break a little bit of that plaster off and then we can go round. I don't know, what do you think?
I don't know really.
Possibly.
Possibly, yes, yeah. If you give me more of an angle rather than a step, it's easier to make it be curvy-worthy.
There's room for that. For the edge of the tiles.
Nice, so yeah, definitely. If I'm plastering, up to that.
Yeah, we just need to chip that off.
That needs to be chipped off like this, just to about that level.
Yeah, we'll do that.
Yeah. Well, we were actually done for the day till somebody had a bright idea, but we're getting there, cutting the tiles. Dry run, all the cuts done. Chris will just make up a small mix now of the adhesive and we'll get those put down. Then are we done for the day?
Yes.
Thank you.
The only reason why I said we ought to put them down today is because we'll be making the lime tomorrow and you'll want to lime that front. And so that gives them overnight to set so you can do your lime.
Okay, yeah, fair point.
Yeah. Hopefully it'll stick to this adhesive that this stuff was put up with.
Yeah, I've got to do that tomorrow. Yeah. If these are down tomorrow, it'll still be fresh and it won't bounce. So these will be nice and started to dry. Okay, I'm with you. Nice and early this morning. If we have got our plans right, if we have calculated correctly, and lots of other ifs that you can probably think of, Chris should be making the last proper full batch of lime render for the caves.
Yes.
It's a big if, you know what our luck is like, but that is the plan. I'll show you what we're doing. And down at the end of cave one, that batch of lime should be correct for doing the edging strip around this room, for finishing this chimney breast. All this needs to be lime coated. I only had a first coat the other day with the last of a batch, and here all this needs rendering, and it's plinthed down there under the plastic.
And then over here, where we did those lovely shelves, the edging here, and then the skirting all the way around this room. I bought you a present, didn't I? Don't tell me, don't say I'm never good to you.
Yeah, yes. It's a backpack sprayer, another one. But this one's a battery one.
Yeah.
Instead of a pump thing. We needed a new one anyway because we'd used the other one we had for construction. And then obviously this one's not going to be used for construction. However, we need to test it. So we're just going to spray the walls with it.
Yep.
Eventually, getting filled with herbicide. That's an organic recognised one. We need to do the cave roof and other places as well.
Yeah. So the other one, we used to work by pumping a thing on the side. It was a pain in the bum, but it did work, but we did manage to kill it.
Yes.
This isn't sponsored or anything, we just something we bought, and we're going to see if it works, because fingers crossed, seeing as it's battery operated, it'll be significantly easier to use.
Oh, I hope so.
So I'm going to fill it with water. Not fill it with water, because it'll weigh a ton. But we do have to test it with water first. So I've got to spray the inside that fireplace that I'm about to do. So let's go test it.
Yes. So this thing has an on-off switch on one side. And it also has a variable thing. I don't know. Well, that's that prime then.
Yeah. What's that noise? What's that doing?
Yeah.
Oh, just did another noise?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, that works. Don't know if you can see in the light, ready?
Yeah. Oh, that'll do. It's very noisy.
You poor deprived animal, you have no water anywhere. You have to get the drips.
You've got three water bowls, ma'am.
No. Right, I'll go spray some walls.
Good idea. See how it works.
Yeah. Oh, it has a light on it.
Yes.
It's a green spalier.
Yeah. Well. Good thing you don't have to pump it.
I know, I'm just waiting. With the other one, I haven't had to stop and pumped already. That's brilliant. Got a bit of a drip.
Well, it was only cheap.
Oh yeah, it was dirt cheap.
Well, not necessarily cheap, but inexpensive.
I did think a battery operated one would, rechargeable battery would be about 3 times more expensive than this was.
Yes.
So,
yeah, it's not a brand name and such, so we all know. You always pay extra for a brand name, even though sometimes it's not necessarily a better quality.
Well, it's kind of spray. This is really easy.
Nothing.
Stop now, child. Stop. Okay.
Yes.
Here we go.
Yes. That reminds me of a song. Two of them. Here we go. White Snake.
Here we go again.
Yes.
Here I go again, not we.
Okay, so another song.
Go on.
Choir boys.
Go on.
There she goes again.
That's she goes. That's we and she, not I go. No, oh, I see.
Yeah, you're singing. Yeah, she.
Just like that. It's done. Dick.
Yes. I just brought her in a bucket of clean water so she can just rinse everything down.
Yes. I'm just going to clean off where, obviously my gloves have gone across onto these refractory bricks. I want a nicer edge than that, so I'll get that cleaned off. And now I'm going to do a bit of skirting underneath. No, a bit of half.
So I've been doing a couple of other little jobs. And when Lillian's working over here, she's going to be trusting me put lime on there.
Gravity's not allowed to be a factor in this, darling.
I know, you've already said I've got to get polyethylene. Well, that went better than I expected. Lillian's busy, so she couldn't film me doing it. And setting the camera up on the tripod would have been in the way, because I was one side, then the other side, then back and back and back.
I've been requested to critique. It's not bad. It's not bad.
Yes.
Needs work.
Yes. I just found a little bit that I didn't do very well. But if I do this now, is that any better?
That's better. But now you need to sponge this down into here so that when it's painted, it hasn't got an obvious between the old plaster and the new plaster. Yeah. That's always the difficult bit.
So am I allowed to do around here now?
Yes. If you really want to, just don't do it because you feel you have to and get mad at it because you've got to be really patient with it.
Yes, but there's nothing else I can do. So this is all done.
I know.
And I don't want you to have to do all the work and then say, look, I did all this.
I don't mind doing all the work and then saying, look, I did all of this.
I know.
You hate it. Which I get. I'm the same the other way when you're building things and I'm not a part of it. There we go. We don't have an obvious ridge anymore, Okay. Apart from it being wet.
Does it?
Yeah.
Okay. So while I'm doing this, Lillian's spraying the walls and ready for
so quick.
Putting the stuff down.
Ready, set, go. Well done.
Thank you.
Good job, well done.
Thank you very much. It was more stressful than I thought. Especially you standing over me, looking over my shoulder.
Did you shout, I've done the bottom bit here to the fireplace?
I've done that.
Okay, so that's done. That will need a little bit of sponge, but I'm going to leave it a little bit rough behind there because it works. So it's coming together.
Well, I'm outside. I'm going to do a little experiment. The bit of cementing that we did the other day, I'm going to try and whitewash it to see if it takes. Because if it does and it looks okay, that means we don't have to take all this monocap off and then put monocap back on, or just put monocap over the top. So that'll save a job. Hopefully it'll work, but I'm not sure if it will. Also, if it does work, that means that we could whitewash all this lot and then hide all our mistakes. So, still doing it really, really wet. I'm guessing it won't show up straight away, but hopefully it'll sink in and it'll build up. So. And it's currently in the shade, so it won't dry too quick. That's its first layer on. While it is slightly absorbent, I'm not convinced it's going to work. The line has not been drawn in. The moisture has, but the lime's just sat on the top and it's just sucked it all in. I couldn't do the lime any more watery. So anyway, we'll give it a day and come back tomorrow and have another look. So Lillian's starting on her task. That's looking awesome. It's there.
This room is, sorry, talking to the back of my head, apologies. This room is a lot more forgiving than the cathedral bedroom was. I think I'll get it done in about half the time. It's a good job because I've got two rooms to do. I've got the nemesis room to do as well.
Yes. There are some large gaps, but you'll easily fill that, won't you?
Oh yeah.
With your experience.
Nothing we can't hide in a line now.
It's looking awesome.
It will look good.
Now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. We'll come back to it in a bit.
Yes.
When this room's done.
I know. So, first room done. What do you think?
Well, I think it looks awesome. Yeah.
It's so much better, doesn't it?
It does.
Little finishing touches make all the difference.
Yes.
So we'll have a break now. It's not a problem leaving the lime as it is because it just mixes up again. If it's a little bit dry, you can rehydrate it. We'll have a break. Come back and do the other room this afternoon.
Yes. And my work looks good too.
It does.
I don't have too myself.
Dover, no, don't lie on that, darling. He likes to lie in the corners instead of off to a corner that I've just edges on.
Right, mate. Should I go up and have something to eat? But you won't be because you've already been fed. Good lad.
Good boy. Did you like the fussies? Oh. That was squirrely
boy. So, it's a number of hours later since that mix was mixed.
Yes.
And it's still perfectly usable?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Yeah. I'll put a glove on and show you.
Okay.
Meanwhile, look at the room I've just done. Look at the room I've just done.
I know. That looks absolutely brilliant. There you go, Nemesis. You have most definitely been tamed. Yes. Awesome. Absolutely awesome. What do you think, mate? What do you think, David? Good boy.
Good boy.
He is. Caught his spot every time I stroke it. Yeah, like that. Every time I stroke it, his skin crawls and his back leg goes. Can't wait, let's go. Yes.
So this has been a lot of hours. Okay, and you've seen me have to put a glove on. I haven't touched it off camera. Still perfectly usable. You can see dampness in there.
Yeah, that is the beauty of life. Brilliant. So, your question is, does this need topping off?
Yes. Do I put a second coat on the inside of this? Obviously, it's had two coats on that side because it had one right at the beginning days ago, and I've done another coat today. This has only had one coat, and this has only had one coat.
Yes.
It won't. It'll take it.
Yes.
It won't do any harm.
No, it won't do any harm. No. Yeah, I would do. Because that finish on there is better than that finish there and that on there.
Yeah, okay, agreed.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, there was enough lime left. We've got to find uses for it. I'm not letting it go to waste. This has had a second coat. It was good enough, so all of it has now had two coats. So very happy with that. We'll now go and use this extra on our weird wall outside, our itsy bitsy wall with quartz and marble and such like.
Right, I'll take this lime off. And do another thing?
Yes.
Okay.
Just a minute. Let me just tell Mr. Wheelbarrow. Mr. Wheelbarrow, you are no longer welcome. Your name is no longer on the list. You are not coming back in these caves.
Yes, <please. laughs>
Leave, be off with you.
Okay, so that's one coat of lime wash. I didn't think it would take, and it seems to have. Let's go and have a look, see if it's powdery. Okay, fingers clean. No, not really. A little bit more there. But I didn't paint it on there as such, I just moved it about a bit. Yeah, that's just the one coat. Yeah, not a lot. That'll be alright. I think now I've done it one layer, what I'll do is we'll wet the wall down once I've got all this lichen cleaned off, which I'm not sure I will do that. I'm thinking bleach or something. And give it a wet and then whitewash it. I think that might work better.
My helper has been helping me this morning. So it's the next day. I've come in to do the sponging. That back room there, the sponging is spot on. It will still need the brushing off once it's properly dry with the little grains on the outside. But if you walk in there and have a look around, it's got its skirting now. We've lost all the joints at the edges of the tiles. Got nice round edges. Was able to build this out where we had a problem with cuts, so that's no problem. And nice transition into this room for these corners as well. Very, very happy with that. I've just sponged this on the inside here that had two coats on it. It's now got a nice finish. Again, it's going to have to be rubbed down after a couple of days when it's dried properly. You can still stick your finger in it, but it's looking good. So really happy with that. This room here, same. I've double checked all the feathering. It's all feathered up nicely. Just needs a rub down when it's dry to get the excess stones on the outside. So same again here. Do you remember a couple of videos back, we had a real nightmare cutting that tile there, but I've lost it with this nice curve. Really, really happy with what I've been able to achieve here. Otherwise it's painted, it'll just, you'll lose it to that. And the shelf that Chris did yesterday, it's actually fly. I've just sponged that as well, so that is all good to go. So this is actually a bit of a milestone. At this point, apart from paint, so dressing as it were, paint, cleaning, polishing floors, that sort of thing, we've finished in here. We have finished construction, plastering, all that major stuff. It's a little bit overwhelming, actually. It's like, we finally got there, we finally done it. Can't believe it. It's taken about a year. We worked it out, took time off last year to actually start the process of just plastering one room in cave two, and we ended up having to take everything off, take the ceiling off, re-plaster the whole thing, come through here. We thought we had rooms that were good to go. It turned out we had to take off that little back room. It all had to come off. We went down to raw, started all over again, tiled floors. It just turned into this huge thing. So we started a year ago with we had this amount of jobs to do. The concertina grew as more and more problems were found, and we've drawn them all in. We're done. I can't quite believe it, actually. There's still masses of jobs to do. The property has masses of work, but the caves themselves, construction, is done. Can't believe it. Yay, go us.
Thanks for watching Tales from the Caveside. If you like what we do, please consider subscribing if you haven't already. Drop us a like and leave us a comment. See you on the next one.